Overtaken Online 3, Cyber-Mage Realization, by Ben Ormstad. Narrated by Doug Tisdale, Jr. 1. Only a few miles from our first visit to the peaceful village Unhale, my personal specialty sensing kicked in even before we arrived at the clearing in the woods. I stopped our truck, the fortress on wheels, and told everyone to get out. Now, I hadn't yet mastered the sense well enough to pick up on the specific type of enemy that awaited, but I had reached a proficiency where I for certain could decipher whether what awaited was something positive, negative, lifeless, or sentient. And this was sentient, and highly negative. I halted, stretched my gloved hand out to the side, and created a barrier for my team. The rattle of equipment silenced behind me as they followed suit and stopped. Even though I wore the Battle Marine frontline body armor, which had a helmet impossible to see my face through, I placed an index finger over my mouth. Hush. Slowly looking over my shoulder at Frida Erickson, Hiko Yuzuka, and Tasha Jones, I gestured toward the coming clearing 100 or so meters ahead, then showed them a thumbs down to indicate the awaiting trouble in our immediate future. Having joined the Godmadrigan Army about a month earlier on Commander Zachary's invitation, after putting our lives on the line during a Daemonorg surprise attack, they first put us through two full-blown hell weeks with a bunch of crazy in-house assignments and learning programs, all designed to mold us into a band of hard-ass, no-bullshit soldiers. Everything churned non-stop until we got spit out the other side with multiple new Battle Marine skills and an upgraded understanding of working as a tight-knit team. We were forced to set everything else we'd planned on hold in order to complete the courses, but it had been worth it. Hence, my peeps now knew they could trust me when I sensed something. I'd proven that time and time again during the last few intense days of training. My sense was becoming more reliable. I couldn't see Hiko's face, as he also wore an FL armor, but the awesome Japanese guy gave me one crisp nod. His grip tightened around the electric soul extinguisher sniper rifle, and I sensed his eagerness to confront whatever awaited head-on. Frida, the beautiful Norwegian warrior medic, and knock on wood, still my in-game girlfriend, even after all the emotional shit that welled up between us during the hell weeks, smiled, making her crystal blue eyes squint between the golden white strands of hair that ran down the sides of her face, past her red-caped shoulders, and cradled the leather-armored chest. The deadly blades of her dual-wielded katanas reflected the surrounding foliage. My girl. Behind her, the newest addition to our team, the Afro-American Tasha, also Battle Marine, alluring, tough, and dressed in a tight-fitted azure bodysuit, head draped in a purple hood, with her red dreadlock pigtails sticking out from either side of her face. She patted the circular saw blade-spitting nightmare gun, the severe severer. As she gave me a crooked grin, the red embedded diamond in her right front tooth glimmered. I flipped my downturned thumb right side up and motioned for us to advance further. While moving, I brought up the inventory and scrolled through my selection of weapons. Weapon overview. Weapon, total ammo. Brawl, unlimited. Daemonorg Ripper Machete, good condition. Battle Marine Infantry Sword, iced, level 1, good condition. Daemonorg Light Handgun, 285 bullets. Celestial Basic Pistol, blue, plus 7 energy refills. Daemonorg Rap Attack Automatic Rifle, 341 bullets. Battle Marine Prez Assault Rifle, 200 bullets. Celestial Energy Flinger, green, plus 7 energy refills. Daemonorg Shotgun, 100 shells. Daemonorg Bazooka, 5 rockets. Daemonorg Ball Buster Grenades, 2 grenades. Celestial Plasma Grenades, 3 grenades. Smiling to myself, I equipped the Celestial Energy Flinger, a smooth, blue energy-spewing assault rifle that also caused burning. In the scabbard strapped to my back, I switched out the Daemonorg Ripper machete with the Battle Marine Infantry sword, as it tended to be more aerodynamically efficient when fighting multiple enemies at once. Plus, I recently experimented with the Cyber-Mage ability Energy Mechanic and uncovered new uses for it other than merely repairing or breaking things. By fusing the infantry sword with regular scrap and shards of glass, it became imbued with the power of ice, making it so-called iced. I'd never heard of something like that before, but was stoked to try it out in the field. Also, who would have thought I could accomplish something like that this early in my journey? The Cyber-Mage Patrio, who had accepted me as his apprentice, had likely been right when he said my innate understanding of the metaphysical machinations of this digital reality would open certain skills long before the game's rules would allow me to officially change class from Battle Marine to Cyber-Mage. Like a caterpillar magically learning to navigate airspace before breaking free from the cocoon as a butterfly, I got to learn how to manipulate reality prior to becoming a Cyber-Mage. As we slinked onwards, I appreciated the play of the evening sun's orange beams spiking through the canopy, igniting sparkles in the droplets on the still, wet, thick-leaved branches. Feeling the slight pull from the sucking sensation around my boots from the moist dirt road, hearing the chirping of birds from the trees, and the perfectly weighted celestial energy flinger rifle resting in my grip, it once again hit me square between the eyes how incredible this game was. I'd been in Overtaken Online about a month now, and I hadn't really gotten used to the breathtaking graphics yet, nor the realistic feel of it all. My sense intensified as we passed a jumbled mess of broken trees and bushes ripped up with the roots. I stopped again, bounced my hand in a few downward motions. We all crouched behind the tallest stumps. Peeking toward the clearing, now only about 20 meters away, I wondered why it was so quiet. Not a grunt, grumble, or even any whispering voices. Yet an urgency grew with every passing second. Narrowing my focus on it, I noticed another nuance. Fear. Like not being able to breathe. Looking at Hiko, I made a wide circular gesture with my hand, ending by pointing at a grassy knoll mostly obscured by trees some 50 meters away. As he snuck off to the side and disappeared among the damp foliage, I motioned for the two ladies to follow me. Intending to know my health points, magic points, and armor caused the relevant HUD elements to pop up. 225 HP, 90 MP, 75 armor. Good. Now, both HP and MP were actually lower, but the silver-leveled FL armor provided a nice bump to each of them, plus 75 and plus 30 points, respectively. Figuring we were close enough to our as-yet-invisible and silent threat, I activated one of my new Battle Marine abilities gained during the Hell Weeks, Heat Seek. A moss-green translucent filter overlaid my field of vision, causing every warmth-emitting object or creature to show up in silhouetted reds. The deeper the red, the more intense the heat. Right away, it was like swimming in a sea of fluttering reds against the green backdrop as the filter registered every fucking thing, including bees buzzing in the air, beetles crawling on tree trunks, and ants speeding around on the ground. Lower heat sensitivity by 50%, I ordered through directed thought. Most of the unnecessary visual static cleared out, leaving a cluster of deeply red forms in the outer reaches of the Heat Seek's operational area. They looked unmoving and tall, like totem poles of some sort, and the redness pulsated, wriggled almost. "The fuck?" I murmured so low not even my companions heard it. My heart rate quickened. I swallowed. Whatever it was remained invisible behind the dense growth of trees and bushes. Carefully breaking away plants, we stepped closer, and I saw the totem pole-looking red things were connected to each other by a carpet of redness stretching across the ground. "Mr. Walsh, are you seeing this?" Hiko's whisper of a voice spoke in my mind through our team chat. I turned my head in the direction he went to locate his silhouetted team color.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.